From the previous shoemaking tutorial on how to make pattern for the leather straps with buckles, I got a lot of questions to show you how to make the opening for the buckles to enter the leather strap into the buckle. So today in the shoemaking tutorial, I will show you how to do that. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. In the previous shoemaking tutorial, I teach you how to make pattern for the leather straps with buckle. The leather straps that has folding, and I teach you how to make this pattern. Today in this shoemaking tutorial, I will show you how to make opening here to place strap through the buckle. And I will show you how to make it on an example of other pattern, of different pattern, for the straps that doesn't have the folding. So if you will want to make straps with the buckle without folding, the total width of the strap must be the same as the width of your buckle. If the width of this buckle that I will use for my shoes is 3 centimeters, so the strap that doesn't have folding and has row cuts must have same width, 3 centimeters. If you plan to make folding, you already know how to calculate the correct width for the strap with certain buckle. Okay, and now I will teach you how to make this opening to place strap through the buckle, through the pin that has buckle. So we have here the hole that marks the middle of the buckle, which is the exact place where we have this pin. Now we need to measure the length of this loop that this pin has, and the not length, it's the width of this loop that this pin has. To show you it clear, I will use the compasses only to show you what I am measuring. So I need to measure the length of this loop that this pin has, and so these 2 points I need to measure. You see where the loop ends and where we have other edge of this loop on the other side of the pin. Okay, so this distance and the length of this distance is 6 millimeters, I guess. Yes, it's 6 millimeters. So now I need to double it because this loop of the strap overlap the pin. It goes from this point, overlap it, and return to the beginning of the strap, to the same place. That's why I need to double it. So the total opening for this pin will be 6 millimeters multiply on 2, and I will get 1 centimeter and 2 millimeters. So entire opening here for this buckle will be 1 centimeter and 2 millimeters. And I need now to mark central line here, because our pin is on the center of the buckle. So through this point, you should mark central line, and to make it clear, make it precise, mark another point from the edge of the strap to the middle. The middle here is 1.5, because the total width of this buckle is 3 centimeters, so the middle will be 1.5 centimeters. You need to find this point only to mark center line exactly in the middle of this pattern. So this is the center line. Now from this point, where will be our pin, we need to mark 6 millimeters to each side along the central line. In total, we will have 1.2 centimeters. So mark 6 millimeters. In my case, it's 6 millimeters. In your case, will be different measurement. Depends on the buckle that you will use. So 6 millimeters here and 6 millimeters on the other side. So this is the entire opening here that I will make on this strap. Now I need to measure the width of this pin so it will enter through the buckle. And the width of this pin is 2 millimeters. So now to create this opening with the width of 2 millimeters exactly in the center, I need to mark 1 millimeter from the center on one side and 1 millimeter from the center line on the other side. And when I will open, it will be 2 millimeters exactly in the middle. So I mark 1 millimeter on this side, 1 millimeter on the other side. And then in another 2 points to have straight line, 1 millimeter on one side and 1 millimeter on the other side. Connect between those 2 points on each side. And this is the opening that I must have here to place this buckle through this strap. This is how it works in shoemaking. It's very important to measure everything and calculate it correctly to have precise pattern, and as a result you will have steps with good looking. You will not have extra opened place here, or you will not have lack of the opening here. So it will not be enough to place the strap through the buckle if you will make mistakes. That's why you should calculate everything. Now let's cut it. And here, now I will cut with knife, but on the leather strap, when we'll transfer it, I will use puncher to open it with clean edges to create beautiful opening. Because with a knife, I can't cut it exactly with a straight line to not cut two more. So to cut exactly this small distance, it will be better to use puncher. So here I will use the same technique, shoemaking technique that I used in the tutorial where I explained how to make opening on the leather insoles for the sandals. So here I will use same approach, same shoemaking approach. There is special cutter with a certain distance to create opening on the leather insoles to make sandals with the toe loop, or to create opening on the leather straps, there is special cutter. But it's very hard to find all these instruments. That's why I teach you, and I teach in my shoemaking courses, how to work with simple tools and make comfortable and beautiful shoes. So that's why to open this, to create this opening on the leather strap, we will use puncher with a diameter of 2 millimeters. So it will enter very easy through this buckle. So the puncher must be with the same diameter that the pin of the buckle has. Okay, but right now let's cut it. And then we will transfer it to the strap. I already prepared the strap, so now I need to place it on the leather strap and mark 6 millimeters. To see it clear, mark it very well to see it clear to know where exactly you need to cut. So this is the edges of this opening, and I will use cutter to protect your table, place something under the leather strap to make holes on your cutting board. Now what is important here is to place it in the way where the edge of the puncher will lay exactly on the end of this mark. Do not enlarge this opening. So you see, I didn't pass this line. I'm placing the puncher exactly in the way where this edge of this puncher lays on the edge of this mark. Place it and make a hole. Now place it on the other side using same shoemaking approach. And make a hole. Now just cut two lines between these two holes according to the mark that you marked before. Okay, so this is the opening for this buckle. And now when you will place it through the buckle, you will see that it has the exact width and length, so this pin will move free, and this is what is important detail working with buckles. This pin must move free. You see, this is where it ends on both sides. It doesn't have empty spaces, gaps between the pin and leather strap. It is exactly as it must be. So this is how you should work with buckles in your shoemaking craft. That's it. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you. See you in the next video. Bye.